So.
Welcome to ESL TV. Next to me, my bro, my mate, Alex Albrecht, aka Mad Dog.
Thanks a lot. And as you might notice, this is an English spoken language. And this is Nick Adams next to me, and we're just going to try to bring this European Nations Championship Sweden and Belgium to you home, and I hope we get used to the English spoken word, because it's not too easy actually if you have like 10 shows in a week with German language, and then you have to switch immediately to English. But I hope our audience will excuse some faux pas, and we're just going to have a great show with a lot of content, with interesting interviews. We're going to have, as I said, Sweden, Construct team of Sweden with BDS as team manager, and of course we have some interviews and some interesting questions, and of course some interesting answers as well. And Belgium, the underdogs, but they have an interesting story and some interesting people in the team, and these are the contents actually.
Yes, sure, we're gonna have let's just check out the page. What we have new, what we're going to have in the European Championship shows, is we're going to have the national songs. We're going to stand up. We're going to we're going to check out the countries. Talk a little bit about the countries. Talk about Belgium. What is it all about in Belgium? What's it all about with esports in Sweden? Sweden is a country with lots of people playing with a really big team. Let's talk about that a little bit, and then check out the other groups we're going to have in the European Nations Championship. The German group, for example, they already had their first game today, last week, I think. And how the European Nations Championship has just worked out.
And we had a look at the bookings before the show took place, and I think we have about 5% foreign bookings. That means 95% are Germans, and they will laugh and they will have some fun with us speaking English, because they're used to have a German language host in the ESL TV show. But yeah, guys, you have to get used to European Nations Championship shows in English, because we have a Japanese visitor. Yeah.
How was he called? What was his name?
I don't know his nickname. I forgot his nickname. But he's from Japan. He's watching these TV shows. So props to Japan. It's a very cool country, and I hope he will have some fun. We will check the nickname in a few minutes, and then we can greet him probably. So we have some people from Greece, some people from Sweden, of course, Belgium, but as I said, probably only 5 to 10% from the foreign countries and not from Germany. But we're just going to try to make ESL TV more popular outside of Germany, and I think this will be the first step, not speaking German. So, okay, of course, just don't be too impatient with us. We're just going to give all this. And actually, we are quite experienced, because we moderated the CPL Copenhagen in Denmark.
And the CPL Cannes in France.
Oh, yeah.
But nobody understood the word, because it was in France. And as you know, French people don't speak English. French people don't speak German. They don't speak other languages. They only speak French. So, but yeah, we broadcasted there in English. We broadcasted in Copenhagen.
But of course, that's like 6 months ago. And since then, we didn't have an English spoken event anymore. So we have had a little cool down, and I hope it will not take too long to have us 100% performance level.
We need a little practice, I think it's going to work out.
Okay, so we're just going to have a look at the ENC European Nations Championship web page, and our director for this show isn't Thorsten Schmitz, as you're used to know. It's somebody new, and it's Andreas. So maybe just Nick, just want to lose 2 or 3 words about Andreas.
Yeah, Andreas Schmegas, he's one of my buddies, and he's now the new director. He's next to Torte, the second director, who is going to do some ESL TV shows here, also ESL TV shows in German or in English, in the next few days, because Torte, a.k.a. Carbonara, the guy who normally sits there, he needs a few days off because he's here every evening. He's doing the directing and the shows every evening. It's really tough. So he needs a few days off. But Andreas, we're going to have a few shows every week. And yeah, I hope it's going to work out. It's going to be really nice.
I hope so as well. And just welcome on the show, Andreas. Just gonna wink him, and maybe Andreas can show us the web page of the ESL, the ENC web page, and we see what you all of you can see if you visit the website of the Electronic Sports League, and this is the ENC section. So first of all, we of course see results and play dates, and as you already told us, Germany already played, of course, one of the most interesting teams in the ENC, because not only because of the history, but because of ESL TV is actually German located, and yes. Our visitors, our viewers are German. So
and
Germany is one
of the best teams in Europe.
I think you can argue about this point, but of course, there okay, patriotism is allowed in the nation. Cup, so Nations Championship. Germany won the first match against Poland, actually quite well without any major problems. You can have a look at the match details. Very easy, actually. Just click on the match and you get the match details. Here you have the flags and we see the result. It's 21-9. We play Max Rounds 15. And probably most of you know it from the ESL Pro Series. Play one map and two halves, and as I said, max rounds 15 in each half. So 21-9 is a very good result, actually. Can have a look at the matchup. Look, we can see here it was Roman, Toadie, Medferret, and Blizzard with the final, and they played against Stone, Taz, Smoo, Neo, and Zibi from Poland. And very nice, they call themselves Polska. Very nice. And Stone actually is a player playing for a German team. It's yes. He's playing for Team 64.
Yes, also known as sponsored by AMD
from the Pro Series. Okay, and this is one of the first matches played in the ENC. We have a lot of results as well. Sweden. We have Warcraft and Counter Strike, both Sweden and Belgium. Take place today, and we have France against Netherlands, United Kingdom against Spain, we have Finland against Ukraine, Turkey against Serbia, Montenegro, Greece against Slovakia. A lot of nations, 24 nations are participating in the European Nations Championship, and it's quite a cultural mixture.
Yes, sure. The games which are going to be played today are also the game France versus Netherlands. Going to be an interesting match too, but I think Sweden versus Belgium is very interesting, so we're going to show that. And UK versus Spain is the third game.
Very interesting as well. Just maybe you can have a look at this matchup. You can see, of course, you have the possibility to play some comments to a match and just tell all people what you think about the matchup. Of course, we have rankings, and we can have a look at the rankings. They're not too... you can't read too much out of them till this point, because in each group, only one or two matches have been played. So just can have a look. Portugal won its game against Italy in a very close match as well. 16-14 was the match. In the group A and group B, we have Denmark and Germany both won the first game against Poland and Switzerland. Group C and Group D didn't play until now, and they're going to play today and tomorrow and the next week. And as I said, Sweden, one of the favorites, top favorites in the ENC, the European Nations Championship. With a lineup, you have to look twice at, because you can't believe your eyes if you read the following names. It's, of course, Potty, it's Fisker, and both very well-known players from Team Shred Commando, of course. BDS as team manager, he's back in town, actually, and because he dropped his team manager function in the Clan Base Nations Cup. It's actually a pendant, comparable tournament, but as maybe few of you Now this tournament isn't played too well anymore, and
not in the public interest
anymore. Yeah, right. And BDS just dropped his job in the Climb Base Cup because it does that there are no goals, and I can reach anything. But the NC, 20,000 euro prize money, LAN finals, and I think this was have been one of the points why BDS just came back. Of course, just to achieve more victories in international tournaments, and we have of course Heaton mid with Potty and Fisker in the team. Of course, I'm asking myself, where is Arl actually? Because Arl also one of the most well-known player from Sweden, the best player actually, one of the best players.
Yeah, he's a very tactical player. I think he's going to join the team later. I bet he will participate in this ENC. I don't think he's going to like go on vacation or something like that. Today we're going to see Heaton and Fisker playing, but there are also other players who will... who are in the team. Players from very good team. It used to be Game Point, and is now, I think some of them are by iBorrowers. And
Just let's say tell the names to the audience. It's Willen, it's Bullen, it's Crew, and Nap, and Hyper. And this is actually the whole team together with basketball players and the manager BDS. And actually it's just a total overview about the Swedish scene and what's going on, and of course the who's who, because these are the best players, and I think it won't be too easy for other countries to make it difficult for Sweden to take the win. Yeah, it's you know, we just have to wait how the season develops. Of course, this is the first step Sweden has to take against Belgium. And I just hope the Belgian guys just practice a bit and had some practice climb wars to improve the team play and gameplay. Because I talked to the team manager of Belgium, and he told us, "I just look at soccer. We lost very high against Germany in the last match, and actually it's the same in esports and any other sport. And that's actually very bad, what you can say. And I hope he just." Just wanted to fake a bit, just to have a better chance, but I don't think so.
Yes, but Belgium is a very small country. Compare it with Denmark or with Austria or with Switzerland. But I think in Denmark, especially, the esports scene is much more is grown much more in the last few years. The same in Austria, but Switzerland is a very small esports scene, and the same is in Belgium. You don't hear much about Belgium, Belgian players, for example, and. I hope they practice very much in the last few days, but because I think Sweden didn't practice very much. They always practice in the team, but with this lineup, when the guys from ex-GMPO, from ex-GamePoint, Wilden is going to play, I think, and Nebo and Hyper, and on the other side, Fisker and Heaton are going to play, and this team, like they never played together. I think they had a few train wars in the last few days, but I don't think very much. So I hope Belgium will be prepared, and they are the underdogs, of course.
I just tried to have a look how many people are living in Belgium and how many people are living in Sweden. I think it's comparable because Sweden maybe is bigger.
Much bigger, but there are only 8 million people living in Sweden,
and
I think.
In Belgium, maybe 5? Six?
I don't think Belgium is really small, and I don't think what I heard from Sweden is Sweden has
girls.
You can go fishing, the nature is incredible nice, and they have in towns like in Stockholm, they have internet connections with 23 Mbit. One of my friends lives in Stockholm, and they have 23 Mbit internet connection. That's what they want to have at home, so they can really play. The esports scene developed in the last few years, and I don't hear very much about the Belgian esports scene.
I hope you're not too disappointed, but Belgium has a population of 10 million.
Oh.
Yep. So 10 million, that's quite more than Sweden, actually. I think 2 or 3 million more. And actually... the chances are equal to develop more esports figures and esports players. But of course, as I said, Sweden, all the Scandinavian countries, the internet connections, all that stuff is more improved than in all Europe together, actually.
And they have much more internet cafes, they have gaming cafes where the people go, and they have this internet cafe culture. Some countries have this culture, Germany doesn't have this culture. So in Germany, there are not very many people who say, okay, meet with me in this internet internet cafe and we pay like the rest of the night to go on LAN. And I don't know if it's in Belgium.
Did you see, we have a German TV show and it's called TV Total. Did you see TV Total a few days ago?
No.
With Eminem on the show. Of
with Eminem? Yeah, wow, right. No.
I was wondering and I was asking myself what kind of culture Germany has, because the first words a foreign visitor learns about country actually shows something about the country he is in. Did you know what he said first?
I got me bad. Beer, Weißwurst, and Autobahn. That's the words I always hear. Okay, you can drive as fast as you want in Germany. Wow.
He just said something like Freifick and Muschi.
Okay, but that's Eminem. And
we have 8 o'clock. I think I'm 2 hours too early. So I hope you didn't hear anything. And and if somebody is fault, our director is.
He's always fault. Yeah, that's our. That's a good in our job. We can always put the fault to the director. And yeah,
very
we
nice.
Always. So let's start with a few interviews. We have a few people ask me, "Oh, you have BDS in the interview? Is that true? Are you going to get hold of him?" We don't know. But we're going to have Sid Cloud.
I got the phone number of BDS and we're just going to call him and as long as it will take till he takes the phone in the hand, just answers our questions. So don't panic, guys out there. We're just going to have a small break and with maybe some trailers or with music. Our director has to decide what he's going to do. And in this break, we're just going to call Sid Cloud and as soon as this as soon as we have done that, this we're just gonna be back on the show and have a few questions and a small talk to the team manager of Team Belgium. Stay tuned and don't walk away. We're just gonna be back in a few seconds.
Bye.
Viele Apps zum Download im Office Store. Nokia X6. Design trifft Entertainment.
Machst du Witze? Die neuen Intel Core Prozessoren sind der größte technologische Erfolg, den das Unternehmen jemals erreicht hat. Nee, im Ernst, ich glaube, sie sind das Beste, das wir je gemacht haben. Da gibt's nichts Besseres. Ihr wisst, was ich meine.
Jeffrey? Komm zurück.
Wir stellen vor, die neuen 2010er Intel Core Prozessoren.
Sennheiser Communications is proud to present PC 350. When a fraction of a frame separates the winners from the rest, hearing and being heard can make or break your game. PC350 from Sennheiser Communications. Don't settle for less.
Hi, ich bin Alexander und vor einiger Zeit hatte ich hier drin eine Idee. Macht meinen PC einfacher. Und dann ist es da, ja? Bam, Windows 7. Und diese nette kleine Snap-Funktion hier. Wenn ich jetzt an zwei Sachen gleichzeitig arbeite, ja, dann ziehe ich das einfach hier rüber. Einfacher. Genau, was ich gesagt habe. Ich bin ein PC und Windows 7 war meine Idee. oder? Komm, komm, sag sie. Komm. Das war meine Idee.
Eine zweite Welt, zwei Fraktionen, 100 einzigartige Helden und eine epische Legende erwarten dich. Leite Schlachtzüge gegen abscheuliche Monster in Adventure Mode. Jetzt Avalon Heroes kostenlos spielen auf alaplaya.net.
And we're back, and we're just gonna start the interview from the beginning because of some technical problems. I think you guys out there couldn't understand what I was asking Seth for. So, Seth, my first question was, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
You're fine. You told me before that the whole Belgian gaming scene is totally excited because of the match against Sweden, but especially because of the nation's championship. What kind of feeling is this? Could you describe what's going on in your scene?
I feel overwhelmed, and I think the players are overwhelmed too, because I've been quiet since 6 o'clock for IPs, shoutcasts, anything. I just couldn't stop typing, and then I had to contact the ESL admins, but the windows kept opening and opening and opening. It was like, oh my god, I'm freaking out here. I don't know why it happened. I think we just made a lot of news about the progressing of the Belgium team, and we kept everyone interested. And well, I think that's where we are now, a very interested community, and that's good. I think the players get a lot of support from the fans, so that will certainly boost their confidence.
The Belgium scene always had some problems because of the lack of interest, and I wasn't too excited about gaming and stuff. Do you think this was one of the starting points for your scene, just to get excited again about esports and just to maybe have a league again in your country, and just to start competitive gaming again?
Well, for some clans, like the Fuse Kids, After Effects, original gamers, they kept trying to be pro. They even went to LANs, in France, Netherlands, they tried to play pro. I think it is because we have a small country, and we don't have any big firms or really good cyber cafes like Inferno Online or something, or Boomtown around here. And I think it's very hard to actually behave pro because of lack of things that other countries have.
Anyway, today is a very special day for the Belgium community. You guys Gunplay, the five best players of Belgium Gunplay against probably the best players of the world. We have the Swedish national team, and you're just going to play with names like Potty, Fisker, Heaton. The team manager is BDS. Are you scared of such names?
They don't really scare us. In a way that we're just going to try to do our best, and we'll just see what where we get. Of course, we know that they're one of the best players. We'll just see how good we do.
Okay, so you don't have major respect for these players?
Of course, we do have respect for the players. I mean, even if they would play bad, it would be normal just to respect your opponents in any way. They don't have to be pro for that, just to respect them. And we know they're very strong, but as I said on IRC before, we saw Deportiva winning this week, we saw Monaco winning this week. Nobody expected that. Maybe we can stunt. We'll just try.
Very nice. Yeah, very nice to take these examples from real sport, because this means you really compare esports to real sport, and the national team of esports for Counter-Strike means to you as much as the football, soccer national team.
Yeah, of course. At a certain point, maybe in 5 years, the whole world will behave like that. Esports is growing in every country. And well, we just have to support that, and one day we'll get there when Counter-Strike or maybe a future game will be broadcasted on TV instead of over the internet.
Yeah, that would be very nice, of course, and I think ESL-TV is maybe first step to achieve this goal. Yeah, if you would have to guess what this match. What the result of the match is. We're just going to play max rounds 15, means overall 30 rounds. What would be your guess?
It's very hard to say, because there are so many things. If we win handgun round or not, I think we can get at least 12 rounds.
12 rounds means there would be 18 to 12.
Yeah.
No, that would be a little surprise, I think, for a lot of people. But Belgium, of course, can play Counter-Strike as Germany can or Netherlands can. And I would say a lot of information from you, Seth. I hope you guys will have a lot of fun against Sweden. Yeah. Last question, maybe. What do you think? Which rank will Belgium take overall in your group?
Well, I hope to get second.
Second?
So.
Yeah. Second would be, of course, just great for you, because you could go into the playoffs. Do you think you can reach the great finals, the LAN finals?
If we could beat Sweden, that would be obvious. But how to say? I think we'll just get somewhere just as far as possible. Just keep on looking forward until the next round, the next match, and just see where we get.
As a good team manager, of course, you have to say that. And just want to thank you for your answers and for your time to make this interview, and wish you guys good luck, a lot of fun, and I hope the party in Belgium won't take an end, even if you will lose against Sweden, and just enjoy Counter-Strike.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Seth.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Cloud. Seth Cloud, yeah, right. Ken, his first name, and we have a new server. You already changed your server like 20 times, and I hope this was the last time.
Yes.
Very nice. Okay, and, I'm just going to enter the IP.
This is the server. Yes, first name of Sith Cloud is Ken, and we didn't have a photo here, but you just go to barbie.com, and there you have a photo of Sith Cloud. As you, they have some puppets of Sith Cloud there hanging around on this site, barbie.com. Are his passwords. We're going to play the map DE Cabal. Cabal is, I think it's a really nice map. Has a few nice ways, especially for the attackers, for the T's to go. They can go to the big spot, they can fake, they can go through the middle, to the right spot. There are a few nice things we can watch, and I hope Sweden also, as Belgium, will gonna have a few nice tactics. I think Sweden is gonna have a few nice tactics, but I think they're also gonna rely on their skill, especially Heaton and Fisker. They're just gonna go everywhere, and the skill of those players is so high that they just go and shoot everybody. I don't think they need very much of a tactic. But we're now connecting to the server after the game. We're of course gonna have another interview. Then with a guy from Sweden, I hope, when we have a good phone connection to Sweden. The telephone connection between Sweden and Germany isn't that good, because it's so far away. And we're now on the server.
Maybe just kind of change on the server just to have a look which players are already online. We have Hyper and Wilden and Fisker from Sweden, and some faking Belgians. I hope they're just going to rename, and I'm asking myself why my microphone is sounds like hell, but I hope now it's getting better for you guys. Okay, yeah, we just hope to start this match in a few minutes, in about 10 minutes, I think. And the map, as you said, is covered. It's not dust, as we can see here. And this, of course, will be a lot of fun, a lot of excitement, of course. Then, as we can see, as we heard from Seth Cloud, of course, the whole scene of Belgium is very excited about this match. Very excited about the their team participating, of course, in the nation's championship
and playing against this players.
Yeah, that wasn't the point actually of the interview. They just, of course, they're excited of playing against other nations, but not exactly to play against Sweden. But they're really excited to participate and just to have a national team, and this means very much to the Belgians, and that's very nice to see actually. And very nice to hear, because the Belgians hadn't had too much luck in the past couple of years, and had no team on the top of the European teams. And actually, it's the same everywhere. It's the same in every sport. It's the same in Formula One. It's the same in soccer. And maybe it's maybe that's a chance for esports in the nation where they don't have too many successful sportsmen. Esports, of course, can have a chance, and I think this game could be a first step. And as Sefvold said, Monaco won against Real Madrid, and the guys of Deportivo won against AC Mailand and
but
Milan.
Monaco was pretty lucky, I must say.
Yeah, 4-1 is very lucky. Yeah, probably.
No, it was lucky because Real Madrid, or what you can say, alternate attacks, won against Mousesports. Was also
it's not very comparable. It's not very comparable.
Why the underdogs can win? That's what.
Yeah, but alternate attacks haven't been underdogs. Yesterday we had a match yesterday for you guys out there in the German league, Mousesports against alternate attacks, and actually both teams belong to the top three of Germany. And yesterday, Mousesports lost their first match since couple of play days, and it was of course a huge surprise in the scene. But if a team could not beat Mousesports, it was alternate attacks, and so they did yesterday. In this case, we have Belgium and Sweden, and of course this is David against Goliath, and this is a match you can't compare the players with, because the Swedish guys, they used to play tournaments with a lot of cash prizes, and they travel to different countries, to China, to Dallas, to Europe, and just have some major fun. They actually live from esports. The Belgian guys, they are very happy if they don't pay $10 for an hour of internet, and that's why these guys, of course, try to train a bit, try to do some tactics, but of course they're not on the same level as Team Sweden is. Of course, we just hope that we see a close match, that we see a thrilling match, of course. And I don't know if Belgium can maybe secure us 16-14 or something like that. It would be very nice. Heaton, Fisker, Wilden, and Hyper are on the server. That's very nice. I know, is this a 50 sword? Yeah, right. Okay, very nice. Now this begins. Okay, I'm just gonna wait for a few more plays, and then we show you a few trailers. Until then, we're just gonna be back right to the start of this match.
Same old trailer with Meg Ryan.
Thank you. Musik, Games und viele Apps zum Download im Office Store. Nokia X6. Design trifft Entertainment.
Machst du Witze? Die neuen Intel Core Prozessoren sind der größte technologische Erfolg, den das Unternehmen jemals erreicht hat. Nee, im Ernst, ich glaube, sie sind das Beste, das wir je gemacht haben. Da gibt's nichts Besseres. Ihr wisst, was ich meine.
Jeffrey, komm zurück.
Wir stellen vor, die neuen 2010er Intel Core Prozessoren.
Sennheiser Communications is proud to present PC 350. When a fraction of a frame separates the winners from the rest, hearing and being heard can make or break your game. PC 350 from Sennheiser Communications. Don't settle for less.
Hi, ich bin Alexander und vor einiger Zeit hatte ich hier drin eine Idee. Macht meinen PC einfacher. Und dann ist es da, ja? Bam, Windows 7. Und diese nette kleine Snap-Funktion hier. Wenn ich jetzt an zwei Sachen gleichzeitig arbeite, ja, dann ziehe ich das einfach hier rüber. Einfacher. Genau, was ich gesagt habe. Ich bin ein PC und Windows 7 war meine Idee. Oder? Komm, sag sie. Komm. Das war meine Idee.
Eine zweite Welt. Zwei Fraktionen. 100 einzigartige Helden. Und eine epische Legende erwarten dich. Leite Schlachtzüge gegen abscheuliche Monster in Adventure Mode. Jetzt Avalon Heroes kostenlos spielen auf alaplaya.net.
They just took some time to come to the server, but now we're just gonna we have all players we need. Of course, five players on every team. Maybe you just can show the server if the director wants to show. So yeah, right. Okay, here we go. And this is the lineup. Team Sweden plays with Nep, Hyper, Heaton, Wilden, and Fisker. That means two SK players are on the lineup. That's the rule on the ENC. You can nominate four players for out of each team, but only two players can play at once. Means SK couldn't play with Potty, Heaton, Al, and Fisker. They only can play with two, and that's the way they're doing. What they're doing, they play with Heaton and Fisker. And Belgium, of course, plays with five players as well. It's Sanjo, Riza, Zolzis, Basie, and Apollo. These are the five players we have. We'll have a closer look at during the game because we don't know too much about them. Of course, they are some kind of national heroes in their country, but on the European level, their experience is not too high. They didn't participate on too much events, and they have been to the WCG to Korea some years ago, but the last couple of months and 1 year ago, actually, not too much happened in Belgium. The pre-match, the warm-up doesn't look too bad. It looks like both could play Counter-Strike, the Belgians, as well as Team Sweden. And I'm just gonna ask the guys if they are ready and we can restart the match. Actually, we're just waiting for our supervisor, Byron.
But he's not showing up. He will take a while, so we're just gonna restart the match and get going, I think.
Yeah, actually, we're just gonna have a talk to Byron if he or an admin joins the game. Well, actually, an admin has to do the restarts then. Can't do both, actually. So, we're just gonna have to talk to the admins and then we're just gonna try to start this match. Team Sweden against Belgium on the map Cobble. Maybe you just can raise up the game sound, so it would be very nice so you can hear some game sound, and then we just let you alone with some impressions out of this map and just come back to you as soon as we can start this match. Fire in the hole. And we are back with the match Sweden against Belgium. Wow, this was a very tough one, but now we're excited that after 50 minutes, we managed to get this game started. Belgium is ready, Sweden is ready, and this can get very good. I hope you're not too disappointed at home, but as you might know, it's not too easy to organize two teams from two countries
all over Europe
and two different languages. And of course, yeah, you know, these guys, they're always don't understand why it could be possible to be punctual. But actually, it's not only a problem of players, but one of the admins just took some time to join the game. Yeah. Okay, so we're just gonna enjoy a map called Kabel. Just gonna explain you guys what are the main points in this map and what are the key factors to be successful in this map. I think Team Sweden will play as defender the first half, and the second half will be played as attacker, of course. And here we go with a restart. I don't actually know if this was the final restart, because I don't have a message.
We should have a message from the admin, and should have at least three restarts so everybody knows, okay, it's live and we're off.
Yeah, and Hyper, he is one of the players of Team Sweden. He says, three in a row now and then we have something. Yeah, I just can agree totally. And the players as well. And now here we go. INC settings loaded. And here we go with the first restart. Then there should be a second one. Oh, whoa. And I'm very happy to announce we have a third one. This could be the game, the match between Belgium and Team Sweden in the European Nations Championship. Next to me, Nick Adams. We're just going to bring you home this match between these great nations. And I hope to see a very exciting game. Belgium has to attack in the first half, and this will be a very exciting one, because we already saw that in the pre-match these guys didn't play too bad and actually are on a high level in Europe, but we're just gonna have to wait for the first half now. And this was a quick one from Solzy. He just threw a flash grenade but then slowed down again, and seems to look like they just want to make Team Sweden think this gonna be a fake, just with the one man being loud, just making some noise on the left side and throwing one flash grenade outside to the bomb spot.
Here came a flash grenade in the spot in the catacombs.
Oh my fucking god. Okay, here is the second restart. Why? I don't know why, and I don't care why. Here's a restart again. And I hope this is the final restart. I don't know why, because the admin didn't give us a message at all. But this should be the final restart. And I hope to see, maybe just to see the same tactic, because actually Team Sweden didn't see what Belgium has done here. And it looks like, yeah, it's the same tactic, of course. Just have some noise on the left side. And now this time they're marching through. No, they don't wait. And the attack comes. Here is the flash grenade, first frag. Heaton, maybe he could have some game sound in the studio. Would be very great if our director could manage this. And no frag by Belgium in this rush.
Nice.
And very, very successful defending from Fisker. He had two or three frags. Have a look. Actually, two frags for him. And this was, of course, not too successful. So they have been very impatient now after this restart, and they should have played the same tactic as in the first round before this restart. I think that would be more successful. But this time the rush comes again through the middle, and it's Hyper and Bolden just having a look at this spot. And again, it's Sanjo doing the first frag for Belgium in this Nations Championship at all. And congratulations. First frag, Sanjo. But again, round won by Team Sweden. Let's have a look at the setup of this team as defender. We have three players just running to the B spots.
And they should be full equipped in this third round because none of them died more than once, at least. I know. Except of, who was the last one? Except of Hyper. They all have a 2-0 stat. Heaton here. Heaton should be one of the best players in the world. And he's, of course, the best player here in the team.
Oh, I don't know if you can. Now, of course, he's one of the best players. Can't, no doubt. And Heaton is, of course, in this map in Kabul. He is this middle figure. He's walking with two other guys on the B spot. But if there's some noise going around in the middle and on the ramp, he's walking back and taking this middle position just to secure both spots. This is very nice, and Kabul, the spots are very close to each other, and actually it's not too hard to defend the spot for the defenders if they have the right positions, and it's not too easy for the attackers to come through this defender line. And first track by Nap against Zolzi, and now the attack comes on B again. The bomb is dropped. Nap, second frag. He has a very good position back there. Now the bomb is taken by... Let me have a look. Who took the bomb? It's RZA. Who took the bomb? Oh, he takes a grenade here and has 9 hit points left. And this attack, yeah. It's one after one is dying here. And this Grand both. It's Nap taking RZA and Apollo. And that's why he has a very good stat right now, because he took 4 this round. It's 3-0 in the first 3 rounds, and it's Belgium who should have bought now, and it looks like this will be the first series round played by Team Belgium. The attack is split up. It's 2 players going to the left side, and RZA with the bomb carrier. It's Sanjo with the only frag in the lineup at the moment, and they're going through the middle at the ramp.
But it's a very important round, this fourth round, because they were able to buy weapons, they were able to buy equipment, Kevlar, grenades, and now this round has to be won by the Belgium guys, otherwise they really have a problem here as an attacker, and they have to do a few more save rounds again.
Yeah, of course, that's the point with the first round, and Solid again with frag, and that's actually a very good situation right now. If it's a 4-against-4 situation right now, because Wilden took a frag. It's Heaton hiding here in the A spot. Very defensive, actually. Just have a look. It's Spacey being very offensive on here, and it's Wilden who stands very, very good and has no problem to take out Spacey. And actually was quite too offensive from Spacey and Apollo as well. To try to take this position too easy. It's Sanjo again. Second frag for him in this match. But Snap is on position and takes the 4-0 in rounds. And let's have a look what Belgium is doing. Do you think they're gonna buy?
Yeah, they're gonna have a equipped round is what I would do. Oh no, they're doing a full save round in the fifth round. Normally you should try to buy like one grenade, no Kevgar, no armor, and a Galil, or try to be able to buy a AK, but they don't frag, so they don't get any money, they don't plant a bomb, they don't even get through to the bomb spot, and here's a complete shootout from Nap and Fisker.
But Sanjo is doing the work for his team and for the players. Sanjo's second frag. Wow, Sanjo is doing a nice job here. Fisker and Hyper down. Before that, he took Heaton out of the game. Now he has 5 frags, and that's more than his whole team has, because Solzhi has 1 frag, and RZA, Space, and Apollo don't see nothing at the moment. And Nap is leading the score with 9-0, and then is the only player remaining without any dying stats at the moment. 5-0. Of course, now they have to buy and they're equipped, and it looks like they don't want to go through the left tunnel to the B spot. They just try to have a luck and maybe a lucky shot through the middle, because if they manage to take out a player through this distance, and it's spacey with AWP, the sniper rifle, of course, taking out a Swedish player, and it's the first frag in this round, and it's a very important one because now the defending positions are weak. A nice grand action, and that's actually standard if you know the enemy is in the middle. Grands, nice grands, high protection Apollo, and this was a very cheap frag. Didn't have to do anything.
No, but it's I think the Belgium team seems to be a little bit prepared on this map. You see, they know where to throw the grenades, they know where to go.
The Belgian or the Swedish guys?
The Belgium guys. Of course the Swedish guys know the map and are prepared on this map. But the Belgium guys, the underdogs, they
look a bit unprepared, actually.
But they know where to throw the grenades. They're backing up. Of course, the skill of the Belgian people, of the Belgian players, is not as high as of the Swedish players. So in the one-on-one shootout, they always lose.
Actually, I don't think so. Because Sanjo, we have seen him in the round before, took out three players as only player remaining, only with the Deagle equipped. And actually, that shows us that the skill is not
nice,
too low.
Very nice.
And that's what I said. RZA taking out two, and Spacey with his sniper rifle still in work against Nap, and it's one player remaining. It's only Fisker, and Fisker comes from the B spot, is equipped with a sniper rifle, and he takes out RZA. He was too offensive here and too optimistic to reach the bomb side, and didn't expect to have Fisker back there. And here's the direct sniper duel between Fisker and Spacey, and Fisker takes a shot milliseconds before Spacey. And actually, that's what I said. It's the skill of the players is very high, actually, because, of course, they play some Clan Wars, and, of course, they play some international cups, and, of course, they can train as much as they want. But the team play, it's I think that's the most important thing to mention. It's not too... Yeah, they're not too well. They're not. The team play is not too good, actually, and they didn't play too often. And
in the Swedish team,
no, in the Belgian team, and I think I don't know where you've seen very nice grands, but they've thrown one or two grands, and actually two less grands. Here are the standard grands. Hyper is not lying at this point. Takes out Spacey. Solid
nice shot.
Very nice.
From the back.
Maybe they're getting warm right now. But it's Heaton with Oak. One of his
favorite weapons,
right? Fisker.
But Fisker is doing a good job. Fisker and Nap here. Fisker with Cypher from Nap with M4 as a backup. They're going to do a really good job. And Cypher with the bomb is way on the other side of the map. He's approaching the other spot, the big spot, the A spot.
I don't know how long Fisker or Nap gonna wait here, because if they see there is no action here, they're just gonna run back, and that's what I said. Nap is going back, heading back to the B spot, because they know if there is no action, it could be a fake, and it's Sanjo taking out Nap, and it's again Sanjo, because he is, of course, taking the lead in his team, and having the most of fresh, and Apollo comes from behind, and it was nice job sharing. Actually, it's the first round for Belgium. It's a 1-6 right now, and of course this is a map which of course has some more positive aspects for the defenders, because spots are very close to each other.
Oh, what the fuck.
And why,
please,
is ENC Radio joining the team? Okay, we're just gonna have a trailer.
And please ban this radio.
1 second, maybe just, or not, don't have a trailer, maybe just back to the studio.
Very nice, all those radio guys.
Yeah, and our Team Killer is a band. Yeah, that's very great about the first match here in the ESLCB European Nations Championship. And everything goes wrong, what has to go wrong. But Fisker takes round number 8 for Team Sweden. It's 7-1. And now we approach round number 9. Yeah. Very amazing that this can happen to us, can happen to the Electronic Sports League, can happen to our supervisor Byron, of course. But I think this is the first season of the ENC, this is the first match we saw in ESLTV, and this only can get better and better. Fast round, of course, rush by Sanjo and his mates, and that's why we have a fast 8-1 and 9 rounds played, 6 rounds more to go on cover in the first half. Yeah, it's very, as I said, it's very amazing actually, because of course it's a national tournament, it's an international tournament with a lot of national teams, and this is the first match on ESLTV, and that means maybe are excited as well, and yeah, I think with every play day, just gonna have more experience, guys, and it just only can get better. Because this time we have to say the players are not fault. In Germany, it's always like the players are too late, or I don't know, something's not functioning. But in this time, our players have been there, punctual. The Belgian guys, of course, the Swedish guys have been complete, and yeah, it's very disappointing, actually, but as I said, of course, there's a lot of points. This has to improve, and will improve, of course. First track by Willen with a sniper rifle, and he has 42 hit points left. Sanjo takes out Wilden. He had 42 hit points left, and Knapp takes out Sanjo, but Sanjo had the right instinct, just aimed in the right position. We have 9-1, 10 rounds played, 5 rounds remaining in the first half. Just gonna have a small break after the 15 rounds are played. Means 5 rounds. First frag by William here against Salty, and this is a fast round again, and it's a half equipped round, and Spicy's giving some headshots to Wilden, takes out this player from Sweden, but he can finish this round. This is 10-1, 11 rounds played, 4 rounds remaining.
And it looks like a bash here for Belgium, for the Belgian team. I hope they're going to do better in the second half of the match, but I think so. Sweden is really a very good team. The pairs are incredibly good. It's going to be hard.
In Belgium, they have Sanjo, who does a very good match.
Yeah, he does a good match.
He's leading the score 10-11. His score took out Bullen, just takes some shots from Hyper. But in Sweden, you can name everybody. Every player is a star, and every player has the skill to just turn a game, to decide a game by himself, and that's what you can't find in Belgium, because here you go with Apollo, you go with RZA and Spacey, who have like 7 frags in total, and that's 3 less than Sanjo has all alone. So maybe Belgium would need 4 more Sanjos, and then they would have a proper chance to win. At least have a close match.
So Sitka, try to clone Sanjo another 4 times, so we have a good team.
And oh, it's nice last one. Track. Not too difficult in this point, because I have been in a nice situation here with 3-1. But as we said, Sanjo, he's very high skilled actually, and maybe, of course, the European Nations Championship is also opportunity for Paris to make a good game, and maybe people just talk about oneself and just, you know, have one Sanjo in mind, and maybe you could get a good offer from an international team or something. Of course, all this is possible.
That's all about presenting yourself for the club matches.
Once again, Sanjo against 2. Takes out Fisker here, and he's one of the players who can decide the match all alone. And now it's Sanjo against Willen. Willen takes out Sanjo here with sniper rifle in a very close distance. But his experience is, of course, very helpful in situations like this. And Sanjo, he already proved that he can win situations like 3-1, just taking out 3 players from Sweden. And of course, I think that's a very nice experience.
Now he's already down. Neb is doing a really good Neb and Heaton here.
Oh, Paulo taking out 2. He's taking out Neb, Fisker, and Heaton. I think this is a round he will capture for his lifetime and just make a present for his child, because he takes out 3 and has 2 remaining. Takes out Hyper as well, taking out 4 plays, and only Wilden able to stop Apollo on this point. And of course, this is a very nice situation, and he will have this round a long time in mind. And maybe they just needed some more practice time, the guys from Belgium. And as Sisko said, they want to get second in their group, and
that's gonna
be
hard.
If they improve, and I think if they just maybe have some practice calm wars, they can get there.
But in this group is still Norway. Ukraine and Iceland are easier, but Norway and also Finland are really tough opponents.
Whom do you know from Finland?
No, but I bet, because all the Nordish guys are crazy.
Yeah, I think these guys are crazy as well. As we already heard, they have a major party going on in Belgium. Maybe that's the right motivation, just to represent a whole community which want to see games, which want to play, and want to see professional esports just done by these guys. Titan takes 2 shots to take Apollo out of the game. Spacey takes out Heaton in this way, and Hyper takes the finish. 100 points left. Could have 14-1. And of course, now we're gonna have the change.
And now to win the match.
And Team Sweden is not ready. So no go till now. Maybe we're just gonna play some music.
Track number 6, please.
Girl, free up your vibe and stop acting crazy. Reminisce on all the good times daily. Why you tryna pose like I be acting shady? What's up, supposed to be about, baby? Girl, free up your vibe and stop acting crazy. Shonda Paula, give it a good loving daily. Now you tryna pose like I be acting shady.
You say you love me, say you love me, but you never there for me, yeah. To leave. Oh, all we do is make it.
music. Can't free up the vibe and stop acting crazy. Reminisce for all the good times daily. Why you trying to pose like I be acting shady?
You're only lonely.
About baby, can't free up your mind but stop acting crazy. One time, make I make it very clear to you. You're very dear to me, and honor of me share to you. Me not unfair to you. Woman, I want to really make you know that I will always draw near to you. But
viele Apps zum Download im Office Store. Nokia X6. Design trifft Entertainment.
Machst du Witze? Die neuen Intel Core Prozessoren sind der größte technologische Erfolg, den das Unternehmen jemals erreicht hat. Nee, im Ernst, ich glaube, sie sind das Beste, das wir je gemacht haben. Da gibt's nichts Besseres. Ihr wisst, was ich meine.
Jeffrey? Komm zurück.
Wir stellen vor, die neuen 2010er Intel Core Prozessoren.
Sennheiser Communications is proud to present PC 350. When a fraction of a frame separates the winners from the rest, hearing and being heard can make or break your game. PC350 from Sennheiser Communications. Don't settle for less.
Hi, ich bin Alexander und vor einiger Zeit hatte ich hier drin eine Idee. Macht meinen PC einfacher. Und dann ist es da, ja? Bam, Windows 7. Und diese nette kleine Snap-Funktion hier. Wenn ich jetzt an zwei Sachen gleichzeitig arbeite, dann ziehe ich das einfach hier rüber. Einfacher. Genau, was ich gesagt habe. Ich bin ein PC und Windows 7 war meine Idee. Oder? Komm, sag's ihm. Komm. Das war meine Idee.
Eine zweite Welt. Zwei Fraktionen. 100 einzigartige Helden. Und eine epische Legende erwarten dich. Leite Schlachtzüge gegen abscheuliche Monster in Adventure-Mode. Jetzt Avalon Heroes kostenlos spielen auf alaplaya.net.
We're back with Sweden against Belgium, and the game is not too exciting actually, because if you could have some game sound this might change, but we have a 14-1 situation in the first half, and this is the first round. with Nap taking the first frag against Apollo. Only one defender on the spot, on B spot. Bomb could be planted right now. Here we go, bomb has been planted, and this could be the round for Sweden, of course. It will be very difficult for Belgium to take the lead, but here we go, first round, and the fifth frag. And this means the draw already. Belgium would need 14 rounds in a row, all remaining 14 rounds, to take the draw and to save at least 1 point. And I think this will be very difficult situation. It's a very difficult task for them because they lost a round and the Solzy taking out two. Sanjo taking out two again. They're sharing the job, and it's Spacey and Heaton. And this is the final one-on-one situation. And Spacey doesn't take the headshot. Nice weapon. It's a P90. And he takes the round. Good game. And it's just 2-0. And I think we're just going to play further rounds. The remaining rounds. 13 rounds remaining. Because of the stats, the statistics, of course. The game. Okay, Sweden is leading the game.
So they don't care about the statistics. They don't care about the kill-death statistics and the round statistics in the groups, because they're so self-confident that they think, okay, we're gonna win every match. We don't have problems with that. We're gonna get into the playoffs.
And we're just gonna be back with a little interview. We tried to just phone with BDS, and I'm just gonna try to call the supervisor of the ENC, the European Nations Championship, Byron. And I'm just gonna try to call him and just gonna ask him what's going on the ENC. So we're just gonna be back in 2 seconds. We'll play some trailers until then, and we'll be very excited what Byron has to tell us. Be right back.
Viele Apps zum Download im Office Store. Nokia X6. Design trifft Entertainment.
Machst du Witze? Die neuen Intel Core Prozessoren sind der größte technologische Erfolg, den das Unternehmen jemals erreicht hat. Nee, im Ernst, ich glaube, sie sind das Beste, das wir je gemacht haben. Da gibt's nichts Besseres. Ihr wisst, was ich meine.
Jeffrey? Komm zurück.
Wir stellen vor, die neuen 2010er Intel Core Prozessoren.
Sennheiser Communications is proud to present PC 350. when a fraction of a frame separates the winners from the rest, hearing and being heard can make or break your game. PC350 from Sennheiser Communications. Don't settle for less.
Hi, ich bin Alexander und vor einiger Zeit hatte ich hier drin eine Idee. Macht meinen PC einfacher. Und dann ist es da, ja? Bam, Windows 7. Und diese nette kleine Snap-Funktion hier. Wenn ich jetzt an zwei Sachen gleichzeitig arbeite, dann ziehe ich das einfach hier rüber. Einfacher. Genau, was ich gesagt habe. Ich bin ein PC und Windows 7 war meine Idee. Oder? Komm, sag's ihm. Komm. Das war meine Idee.
Eine zweite Welt. Zwei Fraktionen. 100 einzigartige Helden und eine epische Legende erwarten dich. Leite Schlachtzüge gegen abscheuliche Monster in Adventure-Mode. Jetzt Avalon Heroes kostenlos spielen auf alaplaya.net.
Zurück, auf Englisch. We're back with the next interview, and it's Byron, and I already said hello to him in German, but I already will say hello again in English. Hello, Byron.
Yeah, hi, everybody.
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing fine. A little bit stressed and busy, but fine.
Of course, we have to tell people what you are doing. You're the supervisor of the European Nations Championship. And as you already said, it's a bit stressy. It's a hard work. And of course, today is a play day. And this means you have to work even more. Could you explain what your job is and what you're doing if it's stressy?
Yeah, I'm talking to the partners and the managers and the captains, everyone. Try to manage the games and try to get up HLTV on the service and everything around the games, the ENC,
and
everything about sponsoring and so on.
And yeah, that's of course a lot of work you have to do, and of course we all know it's can be a lot of work to set up one match, a single match, but you have to set up all matches and just have a look at all matches and just take care that these matches work well. Can you just give us an overview which matches have been played and which matches are just going on right now?
Yeah, right on is UK versus Spain. and played it is French versus Netherlands, and they played 17-13 for the Netherlands. They win, the Netherlands.
Okay, and these are the matches you're taking care of right now.
Right now is running Spain versus the United Kingdom.
Oh, okay. And do you know standing?
No, sorry.
Okay, just gonna have a look at the website, of course, because the website is always up to date, right? Would you tell us about? Of course, you're not only taking care about Counter-Strike, but on Warcraft as well, of course. Do you think Warcraft and Counter-Strike are both tournaments doing well, or are the Counter-Strike are more improved or better in organizing their matches?
No, I think both are same. Counter-Strike is running very, very well, but not this day. It's a little bit stressy. We have to change servers 2 minutes before the game starts. So there were some problems today with the match of Sweden and Belgium. But the other match is running very, very well. We got over thousands of visitors and spectators on the service on HLTV in IRC. So I think they're both running very, very well.
Yeah, feedback is very amazing, of course, all the viewers, of course, also on ESLTV, very amazing, because the competition between two nations is always something special. Do you have a favorite nation? I mean, you can tell us on ESLTV, it's almost private here.
No, I'm very neutral, I have no favorite nation.
Not even Germany?
No, I'm just very neutral, and every team is a team for me, and I have no favorites.
Ah, that's perfect for a supervisor. Do you have already some feedback from players? I mean, we already played some matches like Portugal, Italy. Did you talk to players just to take some feedback?
Yes, I talked to some players, to head of Team Germany, the captain, and he said it's very well organized and everything's running fine, and he's very happy to play in the EMC.
Yeah, of course, we hear this feedback in a very good way, and I hope the games, the matches, the ENC will work out very well in the future as well. And I think if you spend more work, we have to send you on vacation in a few weeks, but I hope it won't be too stressy for you. Of course, you have a team behind you, an admin team, maybe some key functions. Which admin has some key functions?
Yeah, we got BO31, he's the head admin of Counter-Strike. And we got Bashi, he's the head admin of Warcraft 3. Both are very engaged, and they're doing their sections very, very well. And I hope they will go on this way, and everything will be very, very cool.
Okay, we don't want to steal more time of your very, very rare time, of course. How long will your work go on today? When will the last match be played?
UK versus Spain is still running, and after it I will set up the demos and will handle the match reports. So it will be a long day, like every day.
Okay. Byron, thank you very much for your interview, and we're just going to talk in the next days, of course, again.
Okay, see ya.
See ya.
Back with a nice interview. Nice interview from Byron, aka Robin Fischer, and told us a little bit about the background.
Of course, you have to mention. Of course, you have to mention organizers. And Byron is one of the main organizers, the supervisor of the ENC, and he's doing a very well job, and spending a lot of time in organizing the ENC, and everything is working well. And we saw Sweden against Belgium with a very, very unspectacular match, but of course, Sweden are one of the top favorites in the Nations Championship in Counter-Strike. And Belgium, well, I think we saw some very interesting gameplay, some interesting skills, some interesting players. And we're just going to have a look at them in further matches and further weeks, of course. And I think maybe they can reach place two or three. Just going to have a look. Steph thought the manager said it's a dream to reach place two, and of course, reaching the playoffs. And yeah, we're going to have a look. The next ESL TV show will be tomorrow, and it's a special show. It's on German again, but it's something new because it's the ESL TV Classics. What does that mean, Nick?
Yes, the ESL TV Classics is going to be a repetition of a few shows we had in the last few months. Good shows. Mad Dog, Alex Albrecht, and me, we thought, okay, when we don't have Interfry night games on Friday, what do you do on Fridays? You as spectators, you as visitors. Okay, you can watch ESL TV. And we thought, okay, we can check out a few of the guest shows, a few matches. We thought, okay, those matches are really good. Like this match, Okrana versus Skardex. It's from the first or second day in the ESL Pro Series Season 4. And this match is a really nice match. I really loved it. It was actually one of the best matches I saw and I watched, I spectated in the last few months. And this is the match we're going to show on the Friday. We have a few free slots, but they're already full, sorry for you. And a few normal slots, only 6 PDs, so it's easy to watch and it's really cheap. And check it out.
Right. Okay. It's going to be back tomorrow, as Nick already said. And the next ENC broadcast will be in a few weeks, and Nick has the exact date.
Yes, it's Czech versus Bulgaria. It's the Eastern Conference. It's on the 22nd of April, so it's a few days till the match is going to start, but it's going to be a really nice match because Czech on the one side is a really good team. They have already some pro teams and they have some active good players, and Bulgaria on the other side has a few good Warcraft players, but in Counter-Strike they're not so good at the moment, but I think they're training.
Right. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the match a bit, and of course that was the first ENC broadcast in English for ESL TV and in Counter-Strike, and I hope I think we're just going to improve this the next couple of weeks, and of course with every week and every show it will get better, promised. So, I hope you have a nice evening. Thanks to Andreas, the director of this show. And we're going to see us tomorrow in the next weeks. Bye-bye.
Happy Easter. Wow.